I have Shadows of Evil. So what I plan to do in there is I just plan to get all the rituals done, get the Wonder Weapon, get the Rocket Shield. Rocket Shield's fairly easy. Wonder Weapon, it wasn't the start of last time, but since this is a new account, I've only played one game on it. And for some reason, I'm struggling to find my combat record. And so I played one game, I got to round. No, I didn't. I played two games. I played one with a friend. I got to round 26 on that. I did really good on that one, surprisingly. And got around 500. More than 500. It had to be more than 500. And my most used perk is, or Gobblegum is Arms Craze, because that's the only one I've bought. Apparently, I bought it twice, though. And Deadly Ace is the Cuda and the Man of War. I pack a bunch of those two weapons, but I use the Wonder Weapon a fair amount of times. So I'm gonna head into a game and see how this goes. I'm gonna be cutting around so you don't have to see all the boring stuff. And let's get into it. Why do I have to watch the cutscene? Yep, shouldn't have said those things. Now get your panties out of my face. I need to get in game, please. Oh damn. Oh damn. Oh, she looked like she's enjoying it. Oh, finally. I gotta skip it with left
You
click.
bear the mark. You are cursed.
I'm cursed. Oh no. So I'm just gonna get right into it.
I can hear
Sorry, my
you.
FOV is up. It just makes the game a lot easier for me. I can see a lot more.
You're the one I saw.
By getting right into it, I'm gonna get everything I really need to know I'm done. Hold up. What do we got here? Audio. That needs to go down. There. That's good enough. Now, I'm just gonna start by doing everything I possibly can as the beast, activate that so I can get the part, the pen for Miss Lady Goo. I think I'm Nero, I'm not entirely sure. Let me zap you. Alright, so let's get back to human. And I could go and get a few points with the zombies, so I'm gonna get them down to one. Oh, okay, it's two shots. I did not know that. I always end up doing. I think it's the way I always remembered it is. Whatever round you are on, it's one shot above the round you are on that a knife. I'm not entirely sure. Sometimes it doesn't work. Oh wait, I gotta take out the Vril real quick. Can knife these, cause hey, why'd you don't come up behind me like that. But anyway, let's get this first ritual done. I'll leave two for now, cause did I get double points? Aw, heck yeah. Alright, this will make it a lot easier. For the rituals, they're pretty basic and pretty simple if you just know how to juke them out and avoid them. So if we start it, you don't have to kill these guys, and they're basically a waste of ammo because you don't get any points for killing them. On round one, if you okay, it's a great start, great start. That was pretty stupid. I basically cornered myself there. Not again! Why? Okay, well we're back to this again. Oh, that was pretty fast. I could skip it right there. Nice. Okay, attempt number two. Let's not be stupid and corner ourselves again. I'll just stab you because you're in my way. And it's only round one, so I can one-shot. I think one of the achievements on this game is to get all the rituals done on round one, which I don't exactly see how that's possible unless you have like every single player. Like you might need four. Oh, this time. I think you need four players, like all four, to do that. And you might be able to do the achievement with one. I've never tried. I've never actually don't know how to do the achievement in the first place, and I meant to slide not the way down. Alright, I think, yeah, let's go by the other door, and then let's see what we can do. I always do it in this order. I do this one to the right, and then I do, the stage, and then I do the cop shop, and in my personal opinion, cop shop is the actual hardest one to do, because in there, it's so easy to get cornered. I don't even know what perk that was, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Oh, it's Jug. Good. Let's go up here. Break the box down. I could do that rift, but I always enter through a certain rift. I always enter the rift by the cop shop. That's the only reason I do that, because that's always the one I do last. But alright. So we don't have enough points to go through that door. So let's just pick this up and we'll get ready to kill these guys. Alright. Bye-bye. We gotta go to the next round. Because it's basically impossible. I have a gobble gun that lets me buy, like, any gun I buy off the wall will be pack-a-punched. I don't exactly want to use it, but I have no other map, so I don't see why I'm not gonna use it. And I plan to go really far with this one. Oh my gosh, the file size increases by, like, 5 megabytes. Oh boy, oh boy. I need I want to record at a lower quality, but it has its perks and it does also has its like freaking, I don't know what to call them. But like, I want to get out really high quality stuff, but yet again, I don't want it to take 14 hours to upload. Usually, like, I can upload a four gigabyte size file overnight. Really made a mess. But I don't really know how big this is gonna be. Once I reduce the file size, it sometimes halves it. Sometimes it brings it down to 3/4 to what it was. 1/4, not 3/4. Foul creature. But oh, that is not what I wanted. Great. Sound? Round 3. That is not what I wanted. Oh, okay, last time I had all the rituals done by round 3, so let's see what I can do here. I have almost no ammo for anything left, so let's wait this round out, get down to one zombie, then we'll do the ritual in the, room, because that'll be a lot easier. So I'm gonna pause out till I get there. Okay, so good news is I got a double point, or I got double points, and then I just point farm the crap out of zombies. I'm up to 3,300. It might suffice in a long run. I bet I'll get the Pack-a-Punch around round 5 or 6, which isn't bad, but it's definitely not the best I've done. I could have been way more efficient with that. I'm going to go down, and let's get this ritual done. 27 kills. Okay. So, the boxing arena used to be my worst, because I was so bad at it. But let's see how this goes. Alright. Oh, wait, I still haven't bought second chance yet. That's probably something I should do. Okay, let's go this way. Oh, that was a bad idea. Okay, I gotta run it still. Stupid punching bags always get in the way. Oh, he's starting to scream. It's over. And now, from this ritual, we'll get a Margwa. I'm gonna go buy second chance as well as the Kuda off the wall. There, here he comes. I've tried killing this guy with a pistol. It's not fun. Frickin' get out of here. Oh, good. That wasn't the last zombie. Good thing I left two. I didn't feel like running back and having fun with Tubby Wubby over there. He teleported anyway, didn't he? Oh, yep, there he is. So if I go buy the Kuda off the wall, I could buy a Gobblegum and maybe hope to get the one that buys the perk of all. Why not? Oh, wait, purple. I don't know what that is, though. Roll enhancement. Oh. Oh no! Okay, that was not expected. That was not very nice. What? Freaking. You're kidding me. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna go by freaking jug. Because, oh my god. Infernal enhancement. Oh. Okay, let me buy this. Get out of here. Infernal enhancement. It only pack a punches it for a certain amount of time. The pistol pack a punch isn't bad. It's basically like a mini missile. So. I'm hoping we can get something like that out of it. Okay, Jug. Give me Jug. I'm pretty sure Jug's 2,500, please. Oh, yes. No. Why? Oh, you know what? No, come here. Come here. I'm afraid of you. Pow. Ow. You have to dodge my freaking things. All right, come here. Come here. Come on. Done. Done-zo. All right, turn him down here. Oh, he ain't not happy. If I get the Xenometer, oh, I killed it. Okay. If I get the Xenometer like right away, that'd be pretty sick. Cause it's to me, Xenometer is the most annoying one to get out of everything. Like, oh, as in freaking. Oh, nope, that's Maragua Heart. I need that too though. I might as well get that nuke right now, cause it'll give me points, but it won't kill the zombies if they're not alive yet. So. Max ammo. But yeah, the ephemeral enhancement only does it for a little bit. Sadly, like if it did it permanently, I'd be oh so happy. I'd love this perk, but Perkaholic is also nice. But don't use it unless you're gonna go for a long gameplay. Like you better plan to sit down for a long time if you use Perkaholic. And they're pretty rare to get. I've never even got a Perkaholic myself. So, I've done a good amount of, frickin', I think it has three uses, but I've done a good amount of, things. Why can't I think of it? I've done a good amount of Liquid Divinium get, like, things and frickin' Dr. Monty's Factory. Oh my gosh, I couldn't remember the name for some reason. But I've done a good amount of them, and I've still never gotten it yet, so. Where is the... Oh, shoot, I missed the shield part. Let me clear out this run. And then I'll go into doing that. Knives of death. But I don't want to waste my enhancement, so I absolutely need to. Oh, that's not good. That's magic. And I guess we can just point game these guys out for a while. I just made you disappear. These are going pretty slow, so maybe I'll just be able to lead these guys here. I'm going to grab that shield part, and then maybe start the ritual, because these guys will follow pretty slowly, even though they have hops of, I don't know. What's this spawned? I heard something. But, okay, I'm going to grab the shield part, and I'll see you guys in the ritual room. By the way, the shield part is right here by this bench, if anyone needs to know. That's only one of them, but one's a start. Okay, this one decided to run. I'm invincible. I can't be vinced. Right. Let's head over to the ritual room and see what we can do in there. This is one of the easier ones, in my personal opinion, because you can just—it's such a open space to run around in. Unlike the other ones, like you just have to go up the stairs, go back down, go up the stairs, go back down. And the real entities, and they can screw you over like now. But oh god, yep. Just like I said. But if you go down and you come up with quick revive, the ritual will actually cancel. That was the first time I've actually ever failed this ritual. That's kind of sad. I just lost Judd. I'm not happy anymore. But, let's not be freaking retarded this time. And how did that car come to exist? But that was very sad. I mean, that was completely and utterly stupid of me. For some reason, this time when I'm playing, like, just right now, I've had a streak of bad luck. And Death Machine, okay. Apparently I'm not feeling the zombies' mood right now. But that's 3 of the 4 gate worms, so I might as well grab the Death Machine. Kill you, because you're sprinting. Alright, you're walking. You're walking. Oh, we have 2 left. Just in case I get cornered by one, and I can get rid of the other one. Now, for this last ritual, I'm not going to use my Ephemeral Enhancement. Very much, like, to me, it's not that great of a gobblegum. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that in the next ritual, and I'm just going to go guns a-blazing in there. But first, I'm going to buy, frickin' one of the perks. Wait, depends, nah, that depends on my survival, I gotta buy it. I'm going to buy Quick Revive, which will revive me if I go down. And then, after that, I'm going to head over to the, Canals District. Get the shield part, and then I should probably grab the shield part over here too. I'll show you guys where that is. It's pretty obvious. Actually, it wasn't very obvious. I had to run around the room 3 times before I actually found it. Because with the tutorials, it'll just say one of the 2 rooms, and it just doesn't always help. So it's actually right there in the corner. Oh, you're here though. Have you never heard of personal space? This is not good. All right, let's just run around the surface for a little bit. And let's get out of here. Alright, so, Fumigator. I need that, actually. Give me that. I was wondering what that was. Fumigator? Fumigator? Fumigotor? I don't know how to pronounce it. Doesn't matter. Why is the... Okay, the mystery box is always in the Canals District. Like, for me, it's never in any other district. Unless I'm playing with friends. Then it'll be in that district. Or, like... Yeah, you know what I mean. But... Who finds strength only through liquor. We got that. Is this 500? 1,000. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Alright, knife that. Let's see, let's get the knife ones out here. Alright, 710. Oh, shoot, I am down to 3 rounds. That is not good. And I need to be able to buy this door. Okay, that's not satisfying. 1,250. I think that was a Shadow Man. But, I'm gonna go over here and use this beast mode real quick and activate the stairs up there, activate whatever perk is up here, and also the other shield part is up here. Speed code, that'll be useful. Run down here, activate that. Now I'm gonna go. Oh, I'm too far. Come on. Okay, let's go through here. I won't make the other ones, but at least I'll make this one. Zap it. Oh, can I do it? Nope, I can't because I can't go out that way. Okay. Let's go. This way and grab the shield part, then we can craft up the shield. Shield by round 4, that's not bad, but... And shield part is not in the same spot it was. Okay. It's on this catwalk? No? Where's the last shield part? Where is it? Clear debris. Why do you sprint? That does not make my life easier. Oh, there it is. Okay. It's either in there, right where I just picked it up, or it is on the bridge. So just be aware of that. I need to go to the nearest crafting bench and craft up the rocket shield, because to me it is extremely useful. At most times it is a lifesaver, and we just have to have it. To me it's basically an absolute necessity, because you know I suck at the game. But let's head over here, craft up the shield, and we'll see then. Okay, the crafting bench I'm using is in this corner. It's kind of a weird spot for it, but you know, a zombie shield is a zombie shield, so, and also it's extremely useful. Here it is. You press 2 to pull it out if you're on PC. I don't know what the buttons are for console, but V to hit with it. I don't know how much damage that does, but also left clicking, I think it is. It left click? Oh, it doesn't tell me. I'm pretty sure left click is to actually use the rocket shield to kill the zombies. And this thing looks pretty sick on your back, but you can't see it right now because I've never personally got the rocket shield in multiplayer. I got all the parts for it, I just never crafted it. So I'm gonna wait till I get enough money to go over there, and then we'll craft up everything. Oh, this is great luck. First box, I get an XM. Ah, oh, this is gonna be a long game. Only 50 points for killing them with the XM2. And this is gonna be stressful. I have no ammo. Literally, I have to use my ephemeral enhancement for this. Okay, might as well record this part. Let's not get out my rocket shield. And let's get my pistols. Meat wagon, okay. Come here, zombies. Oh, of course, insta-kill, first one, great. Ugh, come here. You don't make life easy, buddy. Come here. Step right up. Let's just knife you all. Nero perform the knives of death. Actually, I might as well use the gun, but it has a lot of freaking splash damage, so it's kind of dangerous at points to use it. That's why freaking PhD Flopper comes in handy, but I'm not sure if this map has that even. Pretty sure. I'm not sure if that's a Black Ops 2 exclusive perk, but either way, that's one way to close it show. Helps. I'm not familiar exactly with all of these. Like, when I first started playing World of War Zombies modded, and they said they like Black Ops 2 perks, I'm like, oh, they'll be no different. But they were quite different. Night, Vienna. Vienna sausage? There's a little sorry, you get no way I can make you okay. Reappear. Ooh, sweet, you gave me rounds! Alright, so, I need to become a beast. Well, first of all, I need to buy this gate over here. Complete the virus ritual, open up the rift gate, and then I can pack a punch. But it won't be easy if I have crap for guns. So, why can't I? There we go. Freaking. That was weird. Alright, that's to get the sword, the thing right there, and I don't plan to get the sword on this part because to me it's just not exactly all worth it. And I don't. It's cool and all, but I just never would use it. But, so, is there anything else we can do with Beast, if we can make it to anywhere? No, it doesn't look like it. Alright, we're human again. So, this can end, like, very quickly. With this one, for me, I've gotten this show, like, 4 times in a row, died on it, like, 4 times in a row. And I was not a happy person. Additional part. Oh, I haven't grabbed the part. It usually helps when you have everything. Alright, don't hit me, please. Alright, sit over here, 5 gigabytes so far for the file size, that's good size. This video is about 20 minutes long, so sit over here. Alright, kill these real, ow, okay, you hurt a lot more than I thought you did, and zombies, and people skyping me, stop, no, oh, that rocket shield saved my life, oh my god. Okay, this is bad. One second, let me pause and see what person skyped me. Okay, it was a completely pointless message, too. So let's kill the Vril. Okay, oh my god. That was horrifying. When in doubt, your rocket shield will save you during any situation. Alright, now, I don't have my ephemeral enhancement anymore, sadly. So let's go up, do this ritual, and then we'll head over to Pack-a-Punch. Okay, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go! I'm hyped. I'm pumped. I'm probably gonna die. Okay, let's just run around in circles. Like, I've never been more tense while doing these rituals for some reason. It's just, like, right now, it's just, like, for some reason, I don't have the ability to... Okay, this ritual is over. Good deal. So. There's a dead zombie. Give me the worm! Come on. Ah! Okay, okay. Oh, I forgot about him. I forgot about him. Please don't tell me, like, the nearest gun costs 1,250. 1,500, but that's the M8. I don't want the M8. I could buy the box, but I feel like I'd just get screwed over again. But let's see if luck is with us today. Let's hope. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Give me something good besides the XM. Ooh, so, okay, I'll take the ray gun. That's one out of the two wonder weapons. I love you, Box. I was just kidding. But the only bad thing is it does splash damage. And I don't like splash damage, because splash damage, it hurts. If you, like, don't avoid it correctly. Oh, no, that passed the round, didn't it? Because I don't think it mattered, like, at some, freaking, like, the Margwa. I don't think, like, the Margwa goes into next rounds. Like, the Margwa doesn't act as a zombie. Oh, come here. Come on. Alright, I really could use Jug, to be honest. Oh, okay. Max ammo, let me reload. And there's an instant kill, I'll save that for next round.
Ammunition appearing out of thin air.
Oh yeah, I forgot, I didn't grab the instant, oh my god. I was sitting there like knifing him like, why is he not getting one shot? I've instant kill. Then I realized my stupidity. Let's head into Pack-a-Punch room and get the ritual done, and it'll say, like, the apocalypse has begun or something. Oh, right now it's the fly round. They're not bad, I just don't like them. Because, like, when you run around from them, it's just, like, it seems highly improbable that you're gonna get hit by them. When you do get hit by them, and then you die from them, it ticks you off. Like, a lot. Like, you'd be surprised. Oh my god, just let me through! Freaking, the time is not right. Why is the time not right? I have not placed the worms, and I am going to die from bugs, as I said before. Alright. If one of them drops in on that, I'll be happy, though. Alright. Let's run over here. Alright, let's leave one, so we can just place all the worms. They're taking a nice pee into a hole. That is accurate, seriously. It's like, man, you are... Oh, can't go to that side yet. Oh, okay. You're just wasting my rounds. You know what? You're just wasting my rounds. As always, just... These bugs have no respect, seriously. Alright, gateworm place, and then... Alright. Apothecanum bagabalum. Giant squids, worms. Everything is going insane. People with... like flying ghosts and that fly, and then this ritual is actually really easy because all you have to do is run around in circles and just wait for them guys to despawn. I mean, see, he's following me, now he's gone. I know, my service is appreciated, so is yours. You are really good, man. You know, that wasn't you. Never mind. Oh, this is a very bad place to hold out in, if I know one thing about holding out in places. But I need Jug, but I also need a Pack-a-Punch weapon. So I think I'm going to buy a Widow's Wine first instead of Jug, because Widow's Wine will save you in a heartbeat. Because that's what I use, because I'm pretty bad. I'm bad at this game, you know. What? Since when do you spawn this round? That's not fair. Yeah, I'm going to get the hell out of here then. Alright. Oh, okay, now you're up. Do you feel that? That was worthless now. Do you look at that. Oh, I actually got him. Hey! Mike, don't spit on me. Remember what we conversed about? Personal space. Crawler? Okay, got him. Alright. Sit over here. Let's just kill this Margwa in here. And then I'm gonna buy Widow's Wine instead of a Pack-a-Punch. Because Widow's Wine will save me in the long run. Alright, and I have to become beast to do that. I also have to become beast to open the door. Forgot about that. Okay, let's do that real quick. Let's activate that, because Widow's Wine, I love it. It's my favorite perk, I think. Besides Jug. Having Jug as your last perk is like the worst thing ever, but a lot of the times that is the case for me. And it's not good. It's not a good thing. Like, you know, I die occasionally because... Oh, okay. Oh, good evening. Cool beans. Has this tonic Do that. Hey! Mike! That's a nuke. I don't want the nuke. I'll lack points if I use the nuke. I want as many points as I can get right now so I can already buy Jug. I'm gonna go buy Jug. Oh, great. Thank you. You're gonna start sprinting if I do that, aren't you? Yep. Alright. Let's go buy Jug, and then I'll pause till we get there. Alright, but what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna split this into two episodes because I'm at the 25-minute mark, and I'm basically doing a tutorial here, so... I'm gonna end this episode here. If you guys like the video, please hit that like button, subscribe to be awesome. I am Chance from C... Don't kill that. C3 Productions, and I'll see you all later. Bye-bye.